Welcome back to Black Skies Reviews. In this review, we're going to be taking a look at the new Hasbro Star Wars The Vintage Collection Deluxe from The Mandalorian. It's the Dark Trooper 1/18 scale action figure. And here's the package that it comes in. It's not a card with the bubble, it's a box. And let's take a look at it. At the top, recommended for ages 4 and above. Tricking headers for small parts on the age of 3, so watch your little collectors that they don't stick the little parts in their mouth. There's the Star Wars Mandalorian logo, the Dark Trooper name, and the little picture of the trooper. There's a very nice looking artwork, at least. And the Kenner logo at the bottom. Here's a look at the back of the packaging. Star Wars The Mandalorian, the Dark Trooper. Same pretty much art that we have on the front, but we do have this little silhouette here, or product image of what you get. We do have the Star Wars Vintage Collection logo right there, and a bunch of crap no one cares about. Hasbro logo. Here's the side of the box. The other side of the box. The bottom of the box. And there's the UPC, if that helps you at all. So we can pause and copy that down. That being said, let's go and check out the Dark Trooper. And here's what it looks like in our beautiful package, plastic-free packaging presentation from Hasbro. And look, guys, we get more of this. I got like 1,000 of those, man. Can't wait to get more. Also, there's some product paperwork here. We have this piece of paper showing the different hands. That's interesting. Then we're showing the housing unit that stores the Dark Troopers. And it's like they can connect sideways, not side to side, and side to side. Who knows? Well, let's take a look and see. Okay, here he is outside the packaging. He's an all black figure with red eyes. Thank you for watching. Now I'm playing. Not much to him, actually. I mean, he's just a black robot. It looks like we do have the white light piping option here. Let me see if I have a flashlight. And we're going to take a look and see if we can get his eyes to light up. Okay, so let's try it. Yeah, see the eyes? On the back of the head, we have this red panel. It's like a translucent piece to be shining light through it. Makes it look like his eyes are glowing. So that's pretty cool. So it's very shiny paint, very glossy. There's his head, if you can tell. We do have the shoulder pieces here that it looks like they would have been like movable, but they're not. So these are actually connected to the chest. We have a couple of little red dots, like 4 dots there. There's silver here on his wrist, we're gonna call it. Oh, there's some silver here on his lower arm on both sides. We do have some kind of text there. So we have some silver on the joints, like the knee and the ankle joints. So that's pretty much it. I mean, it's just a black robot. It's the side of him. It's the back. Articulation. His head is on a ball joint. It does rotate 360. We have some down. This is what I was interested in, to see if this actually goes back. Because if he has that flight mode, you would want to be able to fly with his head up at least. But he goes really decent down, but not back. And it's unfortunate. I think his head's lopsided for some reason. So his arms, they do raise up. Oh, that one raised up. Let's see. This one's stuck for some reason. Wow. Yeah, that one's stuck. So we have rotation here, the elbow 360. Bend and boil, we'll get you about 90. It will get you 90. The wrist, they have the, let's see if that was, that's like the in and out on those. Chest, we do have some side to side. Back and forth. The rotation up here, not at the waist. Seems like a little soft plastic in there. Oh, we'll go forward, but I can't raise it up. Is this what it look like going forward, maybe? It would rotate 360 all the way around if it wasn't for the shoulder pauldron right there. And it can't make my arm go out on that arm for some reason. Huh. We can move it out of the way. Oh, I got some pretty decent splits there. Can you sit? For the most part. We have swivel very high. It's not only a thigh, it's more of a crotch swivel, maybe. Oh boy. These joints feel fragile. Yeah, it looks like I have a nice No. Can't bend it. The joint won't flow. Huh. It's there. You can see it. Ankle? Can we do the ankle? Okay, pivot up. Oh, that's pretty far. So we can get the flight look, I guess. Wow. Little side to side. And don't think that rotates at all. No. No rotation at the ankle. Wonder what's going on with the shoulder. I mean, the joint's there. Huh. It's always something. So, I mean, it's not a bad figure. It doesn't seem as cheap as some of the other ones we took a look at. Don't know what's going on with my shoulder. I'd watch those joints there. I mean, I feel like they're thinner than the figure itself. And this guy has a really difficult time of trying to make him stand. So, all right, it's definitely a poorly balanced figure. So I guess Hasbro ran out of tissue paper and gave us a paper sack, some tape on it. Pull this out. See what's in there. Some assembly required. Guess I'll have to get mom and dad. It's a gun. So it looks like you have to build his little chamber. Flat black piece. The back of it. Here's one of the sides. And here's the other side. And it looks like they just snap together. I think one side's different than the other. That kind of is. Guess, so just gotta, oh, there it is, just snaps right on. Very easy. But I think the, there's definitely a, top and bottom cut to these, the best I can tell. So I mean, that's it. That's it of your assembly. Just pressed together. So you're supposed to be able to buy, you know, 10, 20 of these things, and you can build that wall that we've seen in the Mandalorian show with all the dark troopers that was portrayed inside. So I guess you get these, okay, I thought they were hoses, but they kind of these hook things, but they have that hose material. And they go in these two holes here. And what those do is kind of like go around the arms, which That's so thin. You put too much pressure on that, you're definitely gonna break those. Wow. Alright, might have to try it behind the camera. Alright, there they are. I recommend you putting those in before you put the sides on. Those are definitely very prone to breaking. You gotta try to squeeze those little pinch areas to get them into the back here, these little pieces here. They get to go through. And I guess the way this works is it's supposed to put your Dark Trooper in there, and that should be around the arms. Gotta kind of get that between the body of the figure and the arms. And it kind of holds the Trooper, the Dark Trooper inside like so. And the instructions, it kind of shows you to kind of turn them sideways. Right here, kind of looks like it's like wrapped around his arms. But they don't turn very easy in reality, so whatever's on paper doesn't work. But you can see that he stands there just by, you know, those pieces being there. Other pieces that he got is two alternate hands, and these are very small. They're like closed fist hands. So I'd be very careful about pulling those out too much. Then he has a blaster. Okay, and then lastly we get two blast effects, which I believe go into the bottom of his feet, which we'll take a look at here. See if they actually fit. So that's where that works. Just gotta get him out of there. Okay, now it's up under his arms. That's very irritating. Take a look at his hands here for his blaster. Can we get it in? No problem. And does he hold it very well? Those are little tiny hands. Tiny hands. Holds it for the most part. Oh, there's a hole right there too. It looks like we can put our blaster there, so that's cool. At least we can store our weapon on our figure. Does that go right there? It sure does. So that's how that looks. If you can see how it's all black on black. So there we go. Now for the feet, we do have the pig holes in the bottom. And then, actually, no, we have two pig holes. We have the normal stand pig holes, and we have the smaller ones in the back of the heels. And that's the one you want for the blast effects. You don't want the stand hole. And then we can put this in his feet, like he's raising up. And he's hovering around. Like in the movie when he's out the Grogu. In the movie or the anime, the series. So that's not too bad. And then that's what I was hoping on. We could get a head that can go all the way back. But you can see that it won't. The helmet hits the back of the figure. So we can get a flight. Because you probably can, you can probably bring the heels, you know, the feet in to bring the heels straight. Huh. Get that in a little better. They don't stand very well. Oh my. Yeah, so there it is. There it goes again. This is not too bad. Alright, so that's pretty much the it for our deluxe $27.99 action figure. So on a normal card, you could get the Dark Trooper, the boss effects, the two hands, and the gun for, like, you know, $15, $14.99. But you're going to pay an extra $13 for this. Very overpriced, in my opinion. Final thoughts on this, guys. He has poor balance. He's a black figure. The joints are very scary. Definitely reasonable assurance that they're going to potentially break if you put too much force on them. I'm not sure what's going on with my arm. Don't get very many accessories for a deluxe figure. So, I bought one to see if these things are going to be decent enough to, you know, the army build, and maybe get, like, you know, maybe 5 or 6 of them and put these together. But unless you can get them cheaper than $27.99, maybe like $15, $16, I would not go too far, get, you know, too far into these, because, like I said, they don't stand worth anything. So, yeah, that's my review, guys. Hope you like this information. Hope you like the review. And I hope you like the figure. It's not perfect. Not many vintage figures are perfect anymore. Starting to wonder why I even buy them anymore. So, I guess that's a discussion for another day. So, like, share, and subscribe. If you don't mind, I'd really appreciate that. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you in our next review.